Hi, welcome to Chef Maxwell's Kitchen, where we get a chance to play with Virginia-grown products, which, as you know, are the best anywhere. Look in your grocery store for Virginia-grown. This past summer, I had a really good opportunity. I took a boat ride on the Chesapeake Bay to Tangier Island. What a great trip that was. And Tangier Island is the capital of crabs, I think. It's just a wonderful place. But I ate at a restaurant out there, and I'm not going to tell you which one. But they had a Tangier Island crab soup, which was really, really tasty. And they wouldn't give me the recipe, but I've been around the block a time or two, and I think I can pretty much duplicate it. And we're going to try that today. So I'm going to start this pot, all right, with a little bit of oil in it. And I'm going to saute some garlic, all right, and some onions. All right. And while that's going, I'm going to talk to you just a little bit about the vegetables we're using today. All right, we've got the typical fresh vegetables: garlic, onions, some celery, some green peppers that we're working down in here. But we're also going to be adding some of the longer lasting and harder cooking vegetables: corn, lima beans. Now you can use frozen if you want. We're using fresh corn. We're using frozen lima beans because they're very difficult to find, even in Virginia in the summertime, unless you go to a farmer's market. And so, fresh peas, and some wonderful baby carrots. All right, now as this is getting sauteed off down there, we just want this to clear. We don't want it to brown on us. We just want the onions and the garlic to start to clear up a little bit, and it's just about there. And we're going to add the celery and the green peppers, and let that stir around a little bit. Right. Now, we're going to need some liquid for the soup, because the soup has a foundation flavor, which is what we're starting with here, the aromatics, right, and it has a liquid. We're going to add a stock. We're adding chicken stock, right, but I think on the island they use a crab stock. Right. You can get a crab stock at the grocery store, or you could use canned clam juice if you wanted to, or you can use a chicken stock. Right? But you need some kind of good base flavor. So we're going to add the chicken stock to it, stir that around. Right? And now as that comes to a boil, we're going to add our lima beans. Right? Our corn. There you go. Right. And our potatoes. We got some wonderful Eastern Shore potatoes here. All right. And those go in there, and we're going to bring that to a boil and let it cook until the potatoes are soft, which is going to be about 20 minutes. And when that happens, we'll be back. All right, we're back. We've got our lima beans and corn and potatoes boiling here. The potatoes are just about soft. We're ready to take the next step. Remember, this is from Tangier Island. Now, they didn't give me permission to do this, so I hope they don't sue me. But I'm trying to get as close as I can to the bowl of soup that I had when I was on the island this summer. We're going to add some carrots, some baby carrots, some peas. All right. Nice fresh garden peas. Some green beans, stir that up a little bit. All right. Now we're going to add these tomatoes. Now you can use, I suggest canned tomatoes for this recipe because it's the best way to come out with the flavor that I got. These are canned diced tomatoes, all right, but you can get whole tomatoes and cut them yourself if you want larger chunks. All right, we get two cans of those, and these are 28-ounce cans. So this is about 3 pounds of tomatoes in there. All right, and that's going to simmer and get thickened. And the longer this cooks, the better this is. All right. Now, the secret is in the Old Bay seasoning, of course. So we're going to add a little bit of Old Bay seasoning to this. Right. And let that simmer. Right. Get that stirred up really, really good. All right. And some crab meat. Now, we're using some nice lump crab meat here because we've got some people on the cameras here who want nice white crab meat. But you can use claw crab meat in this. It's really good. It's got a nice flavor, and it's a lot less expensive. And we're going to just add this crab meat to it. Stir it around. And it's going to take just a few seconds to get hot. Now, like I said, you can cook this as long as you want. We blanched off our green beans and the peas a little ahead of time, so they're pretty much done. So now let me get this out of the way, and we're going to get a bowl to put this soup in. All right. And a ladle. All right. Let's see what we can do here. This is gorgeous soup. All right, there we go. All right, this is Tangier Island crab soup. All right. It reminds me of a boat trip I took this summer. So here we go. Once again, we've proven you can play with your food. You don't have to go to Tangier Island to play with your food. You can do it in your own kitchen the way we do here at Chef Maxwell's Kitchen. So look for Virginia Grown in your grocery store, and we'll see you next time. For more delicious recipes using Virginia-grown fruits and vegetables, contact Lisa Lloyd at the Virginia Department of Agriculture, 1100 Bank Street, Richmond, Virginia, 23219.
Chef Maxwell's recipes are listed on the Virginia Farm Bureau website at www.vafb.com.